Hartleib shot off the back wall. Siegel sprawling into the boards. Now Western will send that right through the middle. And there's a man off the bench. It is Mina Chen. Chen in all alone. Chen forehand back out. She scores! Chen! Dangle! And finish on Mancari. And the Selects erupt and lead 1-0 on the breakaway. And how about that dangle from number 98, Mina Chen? And the Selects, electric here early at the Ice Palace as she broke away. And how about that head fake? Faking like she was shooting forehand and then taking it backhand. Making no mistake, what a goal. She looks like she's done that before. The Detroit zone, that was Hirsch. And Hirsch went off for a change. Clarkson now, the man who took the first penalty of the game, is now out there with Mina Chen. Look at Chen, working extremely hard, creates a turnover, Clarkson shot, right back to Chen, she scores again! Chen with the sick middies, in tight, dangles Mancari again, this time the opposite of what she did on the first goal, as she goes backhand, forehand, and beats a sprawled out number 31 in the pipes. As it was all Chen on the turnover. Clarkson's shot hits a Detroit stick, goes right back to Chen, and she makes no mistake as Mancari couldn't stay with her. And that's two for Mina Chen. And Clarkson's gonna have a helper on that goal. But how about number 98, Mina Chen? Stealing the show here early in game number one for her club. As there's a minute 45 to go here in this first period. Shots 9-7 Detroit, but Western up 2-0. And Detroit, you gotta think they're a little rattled as they have been creating chances of their own. As here's the goal once again. As you can see, Hartleib was just getting swarmed on by Chen, and Chen was able to create the turnover, and then she gets rewarded by going to the... Western's gonna have to look to get back on the horse. Both their goals scored by number 98, Mina Chen. And the young female making a case to be in the PWHL just next year at 10 years old. Not sure if that is allowed, though. So she might have to go through the growing process and then get there when she gets older. She's definitely going to be a star as that.
Today's third star from the Western Selects, number 98, Mina Chen. Today's second star from the Detroit.
Breakout attempt, not exactly clean, which will allow Chen to come back the other way. She's looking to split the D. Chen, on her back end to her forehand, she's tripped. That could be, I don't want to say a potential penalty shot, but she was in all over. Another classic movie with Rick Moranis. You'll remember he had the Tikka Man. And he ended up blowing that thing up by the end of the movie. Thought it was his lucky charm. As now, Chen with it in the far side corner, has it roll off her stick, but it works its way back up to Feld. Feld now hits Chen on the half wall. Brow is tapping forward, and Chen hits iron there. And it remains a 3-0 Bulldogs score. As Anderson doing his best, along with the Doomy, to keep it at 3-0, and now they score! Mina Chen banks that in off the inside skate of Van Rooyen. And Western finally, A, gets their first shot of the third period, and B, breaks the shutout streak, or the goalless streak, if you will, that they have been on. And it doesn't have to be the prettiest of goals, but Mina Chen, who's been good all tournament for the Selects, will put home her third of the tourney.
Situation here as they trail Connecticut for the final playoff spot in the Styles Conference, and we're off in period two. In with it for Western. Drive made by Minot, and they score! Good second and third effort for the Western Selects. They jam the puck in for Western. And it's 4-2 now. The Selects back to within two after that ferocious battle in front. Another look at it from in tight. They don't give up on the play here. Good job by Chen to throw it back out front before Lantman is basically pushed with the puck into the net. And another good save made by Anderson. Connecticut beat both Saskatchewan and Montreal, so that first tiebreaker doesn't go their way. So from what I can see, Connecticut's gonna have to be kept to under 3 points in their two games tomorrow for Saskatchewan and Montreal to have a real chance at it, which means at best they can win a game in overtime or two. Check in with Grayson Knudsen.
Hey guys, I'm joined by Mina Chen. She just came off the ice. Let her catch her breath for a half second here. Mina, first of all, how much fun is this All-Star game?
Yeah, it's really chaotic out there.
How cool is it to play with a bunch of different players from all the teams you've competed against all week?
I think it's gonna be really cool. They're all high school, so it's gonna definitely be something.
Does it mean a little bit more that it's Canada versus USA here?
Yeah, I mean, for my country.
Awesome. Here's a chance to say hello to everybody back home who could be watching right now.
Hi,
there you go. Mina Chen joining us. She led the Western Selects with 3 goals. Good luck the rest of the way, Mina. Thanks for your time. There you go. Back to Sean and Adam in the booth.
Thanks a lot, Grayson. And going back to Mina Chen, I know I was chatting with some of the folks from the Brick Tournament here. We all felt that Mina is one of those players you kind of follow from here and expect to see good things from. You know, could see maybe one day playing at the NCAA level, maybe in the new PWHL, maybe playing for her country one day, that kind of a talent, a player that will keep an eye on as her career develops.
I was very impressed with her, especially all the way throughout the week, but game one that I got to call between, with Western, and yeah. I mean, Mina had 2 goals, one on a breakaway, one in tight, where she showed off her skill or her mitts in tight, and she dangled on a couple of those goals. They were really nice finishing goals, and she's, like you said, she's on her way. I know it's predicting the future, and we're well away from the NCAA and the PWHL, but how big is the PWHL going to be in roughly 6, 7, 8 years?
So that's going to grow. There's no doubt the success it's had so far. So
yeah, very, very bright, and with her being an American and getting to maybe play for Minnesota or Boston, or and who knows if there's going to be more expansion, later on. Like mm-hmm. I said, we can't predict the future. We're not from Back to the Future like Doc Brown, but
we don't have the almanac that Biff somehow stole.
What a great movie.
Boy, these days, if you could find an almanac like that, change your life. Here come the Americans, already leading 1-0.